Asymmetrical games are notorious for being nearly impossible to correctly balance, so much so that I literally cannot think of a single asymmetrical game that has actually nailed it. Now, Dead by Daylight is no exception to the perils of balancing this genre of game, although to its credit, it has maintained and even grown its player base over the past 2 years, thanks to a slow but continuous stream of new content. The game has a number of issues, and by far the most pressing issue is the map design. There are certain tiles in the game that are so poorly designed, a survivor with even minimal skill level can occupy far too much of a killer's time by simply running around the structure, and in most cases vaulting a window up to 3 times. Even though the number of these tiles has drastically decreased since the game's release, some of them still exist and they can single-handedly prevent a killer from winning, while making the killer player feel helpless, which may actually be more of a problem than the lack of winning itself. People want to feel powerful as the killer, and these structures remove all skill from chases, so it's by far the most imbalanced part of the game. However, the second biggest problem with Dead by Daylight, and the subject of this video, is that people are just bad at Dead by Daylight. Now, before you see this as an attack on people for no reason, let me be clear that most players should be bad at the game. It's a casual party game, it's not competitive, nor will it ever be, nor was it ever even designed to be, despite what the head of the game said that one time. There is an age-old dilemma of game design and whether to balance towards the top tier of players or the casual majority. In a game like Dead by Daylight, I think it should be balanced towards the casual majority. It's not a fighting game, it's not a shooter, and it'll never be competitive, so it should not be treated like that. It's just way too hard to balance a game with this much asymmetry to a tournament-acceptable level, which frankly is why Behavior has not actually hosted any tournaments for the game in over 2 years until about a month ago, and that tournament was awful. So, when I say the biggest problem is that people are bad at the game, I should probably clarify and say the second biggest problem of the game is that people are bad and then they blame their inability to get better on the game itself. Being bad at the game is totally fine and it's actually expected. However, when you start blaming the game because you don't even know the basics of your own role, then you turn the community into a perpetual war of killer players versus survivor players. Now, don't get me wrong, sometimes as a killer, you just get a map like Torment Creek and unless you're playing Nurse, you're just gonna have a really bad time. This goes back to the biggest problem of the game, which, you know, is the map design. Sometimes you'll be powerless, it just happens. But don't attribute the entire game to a couple of notoriously bad maps and act like every game is like that, though. Dead by Daylight has a ridiculous amount of RNG from skill checks, totem placements, map generation, you know, etc. Sometimes you just get unlucky. For every time you get unlucky, though, there's probably a time you actually got really lucky, but you didn't appreciate it because people tend to only remember the negative experience, and they feel like the positive experience is kind of something they're just entitled to. Now, both sides are guilty for complaining about things, and to be fair, getting bad luck is a very frustrating part of the game, and both sides are worthy of criticizing this aspect. However, most of the complaining in the community understandably comes from the killer side, which has been the underpowered side pretty much since the game launched years ago. Still, compared to when the game launched, the killer role has drastically decreased in difficulty for a huge list of reasons, and yet newer players still complain, completely unaware of how unbelievably broken the game used to be. Obviously, things like Decisive Strike and Sprint Burst are infuriating to deal with as a killer, and they do need addressing, but most of the things I see killers complain about can simply be boiled down to, I'm just bad at the game. I'll start with some of the most, you know, prevalent complaints. First, pallet looping is too strong. That's probably the number one thing you hear. Most tiles in the game can be looped about twice if they're dealt with correctly, which is less than 10 seconds. There are stronger tiles like the Killer Shack and the Cow Tree that can drain more of a killer's time, but almost all of the randomly generated tile loops can be dealt with in less than 10 seconds depending on your entry point to the chase. However, most killers handle these loops very inefficiently, which can let the survivor run around it one or two more times, which adds another 10 seconds. Now, when you multiply that by the amount of loops in the actual map, it can add up to several minutes of just completely wasted time. In a game where time efficiency is the most important thing, this is huge. So the first thing a lot of killers do wrong is just rounding corners too wide. There are a few loops with, you know, structures that have very unclear hitboxes, and those can be difficult to round properly, but for the most part, perfectly rounding corners can remove an entire loop and save you a bunch of time. It's kind of a weird skill to learn, but it mostly just comes with experience of learning the exact hitboxes of all the structures, so you can perfectly kick the sides and, you know, just run around them really smoothly. It seems insignificant, but this is literally the most important thing to learn when getting looped, and very few people do it perfectly. Now, the second thing newer killers do wrong is respect pallets. We've all heard this. Respecting a pallet is when you're very scared to get stunned, so when the killer approaches one, when the survivor approaches one, you just back up. Now, good survivors will take advantage of you and fake the drop and then keep running, which is, you know, it can completely reset the loop and you lose a bunch of time. The amount of killers that respect pallets is, frankly, staggering, so just don't be scared of getting stunned. It's really not that big of a deal. Another thing killers don't do correctly is they break pallets on the wrong side. If you've created a dead zone during a chase when breaking pallets, you can zone the survivor to head back into that dead zone or run basically into you if you break the pallet on the correct side. So, if the dead zone is behind you, instead of immediately kicking a pallet when they drop it, run around the other half of the loop so the survivor rotates towards the area you want them to go. Now, when you break the pallet, they have to run back into you to get to more safe areas or run back into the dead zone and they're going to get hit. And a lot of killers also don't know when to give up a chase. If a survivor runs towards like the Ironworks, the Misery Window, the Fractured Cow Shed, the Torment Creek God Window, or anything like that, they're gone. Just look for someone else. If you have decent map knowledge, you'll find someone else and less time it takes you to actually catch the survivor using these undeniably broken structures. If there's a generator in one of the structures, just let them take it. So if they all run back to the structure, there's at least, you know, nothing they can do to progress the game in there. And yeah, it is a really bad feeling knowing that there's such safe zones for survivors, but until they're fixed, ignoring them and looking for easier targets is the best option. And a common argument there is, well, if they keep going there after they get hit, there's nothing you can do to win. Well, neither can they. Survivors don't win by looping structures, they win it by doing generators. If they choose to stalemate the game by continually running there over and over again, so be it. No one's ever gonna win. It's just boring for both sides. Also, I still see a lot of people complaining about flashlights, and specifically, they always mention purple flashlights like that somehow matters now. They were nerfed a long time ago. The color of your flashlight doesn't affect how quickly you're blinded, so I don't know why people keep mentioning that. Additionally, pickup speed was buffed, so it's even harder to get blinded now. I don't know how people still complain about flashlights. They are one of the easiest things in the game to counter. Also, you can just put on Lightborn and be literally immune to them, so yeah, I don't know why people complain about flashlights. Another big thing killers complain about, this is actually probably the biggest, is gen rushing. That's the most notorious complaint in the game for killers. You know, it's a situation where you're chasing someone and three gens are done before you get them down. Without rune, that's still actually pretty uncommon unless you're kind of bad, but it can happen if you get an unlucky scenario where all the survivors spawn spread out and they're all on one generator. That doesn't happen very commonly, but it does happen. The thing is, the only reason the first generators go fast is because the other survivors you aren't chasing, they have nothing else to do. As soon as someone else is on the hook, now they have to send some guy to go rescue that guy. And if you intercept the rescuing guy, now another person has to go save. And before you know it, no one's doing generators. The game slows down immensely once you start applying pressure, which is something people don't really know how to do well. Again, sometimes the map is so bad it doesn't matter how well you do, but a lot of the time it is in the killer's control. Unfortunately, map control is kind of a way too in-depth topic to cover in like a small section here, so I've seen so many killers misplay, just not slug when it's a good time to do it. I can safely say it's something that most people do not do well. And most killers I watch from the survivor point of view don't even play simple tiles like L-Wall, T-Walls, or the Shack properly. Most don't change direction when appropriate, most don't even know how to moonwalk. I realize I'm starting to give a list of things killers don't do right anymore, and that really wasn't the intended point of the video, so I'm actually going to switch it up a little bit here. I want to address a very common statement even great killers I know make. The general statement is, killer feels unrewarding because it's not up to the killer's skill, it's up to the survivor's mistakes. Some people even go as far as saying, there are no good killers, just bad survivors, which is just incredibly stupid, because you can go and watch any good killer streamer 4K almost every single one of their games, and then you can go watch another not-so-great killer streamer and they'll struggle to hit that ratio. So obviously either one of them is better than the other, or you actually believe the better killer just gets bad survivors every single game, which is just ridiculous. The common killer sentiment is, you know, a killer skill is controlled by the amount of mistakes survivors make, which robs them of a feeling of control. And this is a bit more reasonable, and I agree to an extent. However, it doesn't actually mean anything. If the only thing that makes a killer player good is their ability to punish mistakes survivors make, that's still a perfectly reasonable separation between good and bad, based solely on the fact that survivors make mistakes every single game, without fail. You will never go against four perfect survivors. And if you do, frankly, you deserve to lose, because that's four perfect players against one perfect player. This is not something you're supposed to win, then. People always cite Marth88's no-perk D-Pip squad as an example of how unbalanced the game is. And the thing is, yeah, when you play like they do, the game is very, very unbalanced. However, nobody plays like that. You encounter a team like that maybe one out of like every 100 games. Balancing the game around that type of gameplay would utterly kill the game. Also, even with the immense coordination on their team, they still made mistakes almost every single game. The better killers took advantage of these mistakes and won, and the majority, which are not very good at the game, did not. It's as simple as that. Because of how constantly everybody makes mistakes, the ability to punish mistakes is a completely valid measure of a killer's skill. So I kind of disagree with the sentiments that, you know, killers lack control because they rely on survivor mistakes. They have control because survivors will always make mistakes every single game without fail. Now, Decisive Strike is like one of those notoriously overpowered survivor perks that almost all killers complain about, including me. I hate it. Even though it's slated to be nerfed, it's rare to see more than one or two of these in a game, though. I constantly see people telling horror stories of 4DS, 4 Flashlight Death Squads, and I don't see it. I stream this game almost every day for 5 hours a day, and maybe one game out of all of those will have more than one Decisive Strike in it. It's really unfair to say my experience is what everyone else has, but, you know, like, with thousands of hours of recorded proof that there really aren't as many of these fabled Death Squads as people say, I think it's pretty fair to say that people blow this way out of proportion. Yeah, if you go against a team with 4 Decisive Strikes, you're gonna have a really bad time. How often will that happen? Almost never. Basically, my overall point is Dead by Daylight is not nearly as bad for either side as people think it is. Survivors are definitely stronger than killers, but the gap is starting to close between the two sides after several years. The game is honestly in the best state it's been since, you know, it came out, and the community would be a lot better off if they just practiced more and stopped villainizing the other side. Also, people need to stop trying to balance this game as if it were a tournament-ready esport. It's not, nor will it ever be. RNG is a core component of the game, and that alone prevents any type of competitive play. For every type of game, you know, you get run around for 5 gens as a killer, there's another game where the first survivor hooked dies because his teammates are terrible and no one saves him. It can be frustrating for both sides. I think it's better to just accept that and move on to the next game, where something new will happen.